After claiming the knight's power, Kutaro vanquished Tiger and escaped the Black Castle with the witch, Yin-Yang, and Picarina. Where would fate lead them next? Act 2 starts here. At long last, Kutaro and his new friend Picarina were free of Castle Grizzlestein, borne to safety by the witch's magic. Our fugitives needed a safe place to hide, and so they chose Castle Waxwane, the same flying palace from which the Moon Goddess once ruled. In those better days, the White Castle was resplendent, a sight to behold. But the tides of darkness had since dulled its sparkle and loosened the stone of its walls and columns.
There, there, sweeties. We'll just hide out here for a spell.
But, like, this is Castle Waxwane. Doesn't it belong to...
the goddess? Yes, indeed. Although palace and master alike seem to have come apart at the seams.
Silence, Yin-Yang! No one asked for your opinion!
Out of the darkness and into the light, Kutaro had gone from Black Castle to White.
Oh, this is more like it. No Moon Bear King spies and lackeys to follow our every move.
Uh-huh. You've got a lot of gumption, you know that? Only one hiney should be warming that throne, and it doesn't have warts on it.
The Moon Goddess is gone, Dandelion! I'm sure the palace is delighted to have such a promising new master.
Promising? Try pompous!
Try shutting up! Oh, my little Earth Sense Savior, why, you're nothing short of a hero! Come, be a good child and let me have a gander at that moonstone shard.
Don't do it, Kutaro! Calibris, the moonstone, and the palace all belong to the goddess. And this magic slinging loony is obviously trying to dupe you out of them.
How can you say such a thing? All I want is what's best for Pom. What's his name?
Whatever.
Granny's trying to explain, so knock it off!
Ow! Oh my gosh! What a witch!
The Moon Bear King kidnapped Kutaro's soul while he was sleeping. He does that to Earth children. And that's where the moonstone comes in. The source of all moonlight. After the Moon Bear King shattered the stone, he gave the pieces to his generals. And you see how they shine. That's just one shot. Imagine the power I would have if you collected them all! Could easily spirit Kutaro back home to her.
You really mean it?
It's in your best interest too, my sweet. Didn't you say the Sun Princess was searching for the Moon Goddess?
Yeah. Why?
The Moonstone is a symbol of the goddess's power. Restore the stone, restore the goddess. This could be your big chance. You should start in the Moonwood. General Rat has another Moonstone shard, and you're going to get it back.
I still don't trust you. You're using Kutaro, and I am so going to prove it.
You'll have to catch him first.
Oops! Hey, Kutaro!
And remember, you can tell a rat if you smell a rat. Go get him!
Well, Kutaro had taken the Moon Witch plunge, and now he found himself in a secluded grove in the Moonwood.
That hag is such a... ugh! How are we gonna find one lousy rodent in a place this big?
I love this forest. One gullible woodland creature after the other.
What's going on?
A splash of purple later, and the quiet, unassuming grove had transformed into a gloomy, reeking landscape of evil, dark horribleness.
Once I darkify the Moonwood and offer it to the Moonbear King as a tribute, I will be uneasily streaked.
So that's who did this, General Rat.
Now, bamboo generally tend to be upright citizens, but these storks have grown fangs and wanted to chow down on Kutaro. If I might share a bit of moon lore, have you heard this one? Once upon a time, there was a lineage of radiant moon princesses who began their lives as tiny babies inside bamboo stalks. But then, one of the princesses' souls had a little mishap and wound up in a bamboo stalk on Earth by accident. Sort of the opposite of young Kutaro here.
Forget about Kutaro. How can you bring up radiant princesses and not mention me? Do your job, please.
How dare you question your narrator? I'm omniscient. Things worked out, of course, as they do in all modern sanitized fairy tales. The princess made it home to the moon and lived happily ever after. The question now is whether Kutaro's story will be as kind to him. Koi-Nobori are an old tradition representing the carp as he swims his way up the waterfall to become a dragon. They're symbols of growing up healthy and strong.
I know that, but who put them up?
Oh, let's not get mired in details. Aren't you in a hurry?
Thank you.
Rat's purple goo had already fouled up the Moonwood's pristine water supply, transforming the local carp into ferocious demon fish who took none too kindly to trespassers.
Hey, you don't suppose the rat is hiding out upriver at the top of the waterfall?
Kutaro arrived at a bridge that arched a truly impressive waterfall.
Holy cascade! Do we really have to climb this thing? Keep climbing and don't look down!
Unlike wild carp, which are a sort of grayish-brown, the koi is a domesticated variety prized for its panoply of colors. Right now, Kutaro is hitching a ride on a Yamabuki gold. But I'm personally much fonder of the tricolored sankei. Something about those sublimely balanced splotches of red and black upon that fishy white canvas. Oh, it sends me into rapture.
That's nice, Jock, but this is a streamer. It's made of polyester. Golden polyester, but it still ain't breathing. tree! And it's in full bloom! This is awesome!
Sakura! Sakura! Dying forest, you can see!
Darn that rat! He ruins everything!
Before their very eyes, General Rat transformed the cherry tree into a baleful twist of briars. The darkness, the old cherry tree could go back to his usual agenda, standing tall, looking blooming radiant. In the mystical cave behind the waterfall, our hero stumbled upon a strange scroll that could only be important.
Magic! Somebody doesn't want us to have that scroll.
And that was how Kutaro acquired the ninja's powers.
Nin-nin! Ninja! Splendid, Kutaro. Now you have the knight's powers and the ninja. Who turned out the lights? Luna Candela! Funny? That usually works. Kutaro, use the ninja's powers to light up the cave. Basil, we're trading! I said shoo, Missy! That's it! Luna Kazoo!
It's still dark. Do it again.
I don't have all day!
Good. Just a little brighter now.
In from above.
That's a boy. Finally, we can have some light in.
Wait! Now it's too bright! Blast it! You can see all my warts!
Here, aim for that bomb symbol at your feet.
Don't throw it! Set it down! Don't throw it! Set it down!
All right, one final test. Hit me with a bomb! In!
What's more, tadpole? Keep going! Bring it on! In!
I hereby certify you ninja proficient. In.
The Moonwood Shrine. Time to spruce up the spruces.
Whoa! Holy sacrilege!
Oh, the horror! Rat squeaked with satisfaction at his handiwork. The hallowed shrine of the forest gods had been transformed, corrupted. Kutaro snipped the ghastly lantern down to size and returned the shrine to normal. The Tori gate guarding the shrine had been sapped of its power by sorcerer's chains. Calibrus and the ninja's powers to fell his enemies and rekindle the shrine's power, one step at a time. Transformed into a weaver, one of the Moonbear King's faithful servants, who seemed quite intent that Kutaro join the club.
Kutaro, did you see that? Stick a bomb on that glowing Taiko drum.
What a fight it was! as Kutaro dodged scalding flames and swinging death and leapt from Taiko to Taiko. Kutaro! The shrine's weaver had been vanquished, and the souls of the children it held captive returned to Earth.
Calibras! No! My scissors! I don't want to go back to being!
What is going on? But this had better be important, or else. Then what? Rats is supposed to be guarding that forest. Talk to him. Yes, he would say that. The buffoon!
He and Tiger. I'm beginning to think the problem with my generals is that I have any! With this week's conspiracy, they steal Calibus, they escape my castle, now they conveniently find the Moonwood. Do you think someone else is pulling the strings?
Right, keep a close eye on them. I shall take matters into my own claws. Never fear, you beautiful brute. You just need to find their ringleader. And then, what you do, you can tear them into tiny and threatening little bits! Put toxin production on hold. Kutaro has been spotted in the Moonwood.
Then the rat has failed in his task. Say the word, sire, and I will strike your enemies down.
Very well. Crush the life out of Kutaro, no matter the cost, and you will be well rewarded.
The reward is in the crushing. Watch as I devour all that stands in my path.